that people will forget what you said, people will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you made them feel. Hello and a very good afternoon, one and all present over here. I, Bindi Bhatt, Assistant Professor of Citizen Department of Power University, feels a great pleasure to welcome you all in the webinar. I would also like to extend my warm welcome to our expert speaker, Mr. Priyank Bhatt, who is an LDM, Lead Data Manager in IQVIA. See, as we all know that COVID-19 has not only changed our style of living, but also the style of education. And online learning has defined a new learning approach towards education, which helped us to get knowledge from everywhere. And in this dreadful situation where it is very much important to work since graduation starts, that's how we come across a topic, business etiquettes or corporate etiquettes, which is much needful when we are at workplace. As being courteous and polite seems easy on the surface, but when practiced regularly and genuinely, this can have a huge positive impact on our career and life success. Here, our guest speaker, Mr. Priyank Bhatt, who is in corporate field for last 15 years, will enlighten us with the information and knowledge which will ensure inspiration to grow in our respective professional career. Welcome, sir. Please share your valuable knowledge here for corporate decades.
Thank you. Thank you, Bindi. Thanks for inviting and allowing me to come for this webinar and give the presentation on the corporate etiquettes. Thank you so much, Bindi. So without wasting the time, let's start. So myself, Priyank Bhatt, you can see I'm a lead data manager at IQVIA. So I'm gonna give you presentation on the corporate etiquettes. So let's start. So we'll start with the definition. The corporate etiquettes refers to the set of rules an individual must follow while he is at work. One must respect his organization and maintain the decorum of place. So basically, I want to tell you this definition I have taken from the google.com. I use the search option, definition of corporate etiquettes, and I found this definition. But do you think this is the correct definition? No, I don't think this is the correct definition. So you can see the red colored sentence there, a set of rules. So etiquette is not a set of rules. It is just a guidelines. No one is gonna force you to follow these etiquettes, but this is just the guidelines that you can follow. You can leave your impression there. An individual must follow. This must follow also should be converted to should follow. One should respect his organization and maintain the decorum of the place. So this is the definition. So I have tried to create definition for myself and for yourself to make it simple. So etiquettes refers to good manners, which helps transform a man into a gentleman at the workplace. You have to make yourself proper. You need to communicate in a proper way. You have to behave in a proper way in the workplace. This is the corporate etiquettes. So what is the need for the etiquettes? Why we want to have this etiquette in corporate culture? You know, so first thing, it will it makes you a cultured individuals. You know this, the first impression is the last impression. So make sure wherever you go, you leave your impression there. Etiquette teaches you how to talk, how to walk, and how to behave with the society. Etiquette is essential for the everlasting first impression. Again, you can mention that first impression is the last impression. Correct? The etiquette enables individual to earn respects, appreciation in the society. Now, it will develop your personality also in the corporate, if you follow these etiquettes. Okay, so coming to the general etiquettes. So study emotional intelligence. See, when you are in the corporate, First thing, you need to understand, the one of the most critical business etiquette skill. This is the critical thing. It involves behaving with the emotional intelligence. It refers to one's ability to put your own feelings aside and see the things from the perspective of other people. So you need to understand how other people are feeling, okay? And then you behave with that with those people. Second thing, dress for your roles. So of course you need to dress it properly. Make sure that you have a proper dress code for yourself. Have a simple kind of shirt, simple kind of pant, formal pant shirt. I would say formal pant shirt is the best option. You can dress accordingly, correct? So if you want to become a funky there, I don't think that is the correct place for you. Nobody is gonna like you if you are funky in the corporate world. They will say this guy is not like, those kind of dress code always leave the impression that this person is not from the, he is not here to work. He came here just for the time pass. So this kind of code, sometimes give your impression. So make sure that you have a proper dress code. Okay. You should have a clean shave. And for ladies, I would say that ladies should come with the minimum makeup. So, if ladies do the proper makeup and come for the corporate world, definitely that will also, that will also interrupt the male workers. So it's always advisable that ladies come with low makeup. Be on the time. So don't make yourself Salman Khan. I would like to give example of Salman Khan. I have seen in the newspaper that Salman Khan don't come for the shooting on the time. Why, when he is not coming on the shooting for the time, entire day get wasted for many workers. There is a spotlight person, directors, everybody is waiting for him and he is not coming on the time. So what do you think? He is earning the respect? No, he is not earning the respect. So make sure that you give respect to the time, to your colleagues, correct? You need to understand, if I am not coming on the time, definitely the people who are waiting for my opinion, people are waiting for my approval, they have to wait for, and their days is getting wasted. So make sure that you be on the time. You need mind your P's and Q's, right? So always try to say please. Always tell thank you to the people if they are helping you. And see, this is this part is not that you can learn. This should come in your behavior. So if you are learning that, how to tell please, how to tell thank you, no, this is not gonna work. Try to make sure that you are really telling them thank you. When the person is helping you, you are telling them please, you are telling them thank you. See, in fact, it is observed that 80% of employees say that they would be willing to work harder for an appreciative boss. If boss is saying thank you, oh, you have done a great job, thank you. 70% would be happier at the job if their boss thanked them more regularly. So do you think you don't want to create the hostile situation in the work culture, right? Try to say thank you, try to say please. Don't behave that you are boss. Don't yell at someone. This is the behavior we should follow. This will create a proper work culture in the corporate. Turn off mobile in the meetings. Correct? You should turn off your mobile in the meetings. There is a possibility that people may keep phone on during the meeting itself, and there is a flow in the meeting and someone phone rings, that time that flow disturb. Better you keep your phone switch off. I would say people sometimes keep their phone on the, on the vibrate mode, but I don't think vibrate mode will help, because vibration is also ringing. That is also disturbing other people. One thing you can do, if you want to keep your mobile on, you can keep on the silent mode, but make sure that phone is not ringing or it is not vibrating. This is one thing that you can follow. In case if you feel that your mobile is really needed that time. So lunch etiquettes. You see, there is a planned lunch with the customer, and you are invited there. Actually, when there is a planned lunch and you are invited, we are creating the environment where we can discuss some business points, correct? So when we discuss, when we want to discuss the business points, and you keep your attention for the food, you are very hungry and you want to have the food properly. So what will happen? Your attention will go inside the food. Complete business talk will get failed. So make sure that you have a minimum, though it is a lunch, you are actually invited for the lunch. You are actually invited the food, but make sure that you have some snack before that, so that you don't go empty stomach and your attention moved from food to business, and you can talk about the business itself. Respect other people's times. So these points I already mentioned, that you don't have to be Salman Khan, right? Don't feel that I am something. People have to wait for my time. If you achieved some, if you are at some, higher position, don't feel that I am the boss. No, respect other people's time. Make sure that you are also giving time for other time, which you also allocate your time for others also. Learn how to remember the names. So if you see, when you're going into the hotel and if you want to have a cup of tea, and if you call the waiter, give me this tea. So that's, this is like fine. This is fine, it's a simple thing. But let's say you are going to that hotel regularly for having a tea. That time, if you call, let's say waiter name is Ramesh, and if you tell that, Ramesh, can you get me a cup of tea? So definitely that person will remember, he will feel that, okay, he knows me properly. It's not like that no one is knowing me. So he will feel like apna apan, he will get the cup of tea for you, and it will always take care of your needs also. So remember, you remember the names. Here, I just want to mention one more thing. So maybe currently you are in the college, there is a possibility that you give respect to your fellow colleagues, and you may, there is a possibility in the college that people speak to each other with the sir and ma'am. Let's say if I want to call Bindi ma'am, so I will put the word Bindi ma'am. But in the corporate, they will just take your name. Whether you are 80 years of old, whether you are 60 years of old, even 20 years of old person can call Bindi. Correct? So you just have to take the name. This kind of culture that will make people understand that everybody is on the same level. No one is boss here. No one is junior here. No one is senior here. And definitely, initially, when you are in the corporate, definitely you will feel awkward that why this person is 60 years of old and people are calling them with his name. No. So make sure that you adjust yourself for this kind of situation. And definitely when you are in the corporate and you become this, if your age is 60, then definitely the junior will tell you, junior will call you with your name itself. Active listening. So active listening is a part where, first thing you need to understand that even though you are a well-educated person, you know everything, you know how to handle the team, you know actual practice, but when someone is talking, behave that you are not, you don't know anything. You don't know anything. Try to understand, try to get the knowledge from that person. There is a possibility that person may have some, that person may have new ideas. So if you develop this skill, definitely you get the new ideas. You can learn something new from the person. And it is also important then, everyone wants to feel heard. If someone is speaking, if nobody is hearing to them, he will feel awkward. There is no place for me in this corporate. Why I'm working here? So if someone is speaking, listen to them, even though that is not proper, just try to give the time. Okay, so we are listening like that. MVA slogan. You should use MVA slogan. We are listening. And gossips. I would say avoid gossiping. It is a worst scenario. Usually in the corporate, nobody is interested in the gossip. You have the work, you do your work, complete your work and go your home. What other people are doing, what other people are thinking for others. If you have the time, do you think you will have the time for this? Why you want to spend time for this? Complete your work, do your work, go home. If you involve yourself in gossiping, definitely there is one day will come, you will yourself see yourself, you will provide yourself in the gossiping. One day people will gossip about you. So it's better avoid gossiping. That's a big business etiquette. No. Even if you don't believe, karma will catch you with you eventually. So make sure your karma definitely work against you also. Keep office interaction positive and quench on your own time. Do your work and go your home. That's the policy you should use. Demonstrate empathy. So even the people who seems most well educated can sometimes encounter rough patches that impact your productivity and behavior on the job. So before criticizing someone for making a mistake or missing a deadline or shaming someone for inappropriate office behavior, good business etiquette is trying to put yourself in their shoes. Simply asking what's happening, whether you can help, can go a long way. This doesn't mean you need to become an office ring, but it's much easier to understand why someone is slamming phone down or taking multiple smoke breaks. If you know they are going through a breakup or dealing with the stress. Okay, to make sure that you show your empathy also. Always keep positive attitude. So let's say you are working on some work, you are working somewhere, you are doing some work and you encountered a problem. You have promised the customer that we are going to deliver work done on this date. Tomorrow we are going to deliver work done, and you encounter problem on the one day before the time, and you think that with this problem I'm not gonna send complete work to the client. What you will do? You will start panicking, you will start yelling someone. No, that's not the easy way. First you need to make sure, you need to understand that, see, you have the problem in your hand. Make sure that you properly work on that problem. The first thing come into your mind, how to resolve this problem, right? Instead of panicking, the first thing should come in your mind, how to resolve this problem. Okay, this is the problem you have, that's fine. That's fine. Problem is there, now you can't do anything. You have only one option, resolve it. Call your team member, check with your team member, ask for the resolution, and if you get the resolution, there is a possibility that in the 50% case you may get the resolution and you may get out of this panic. So better keep a positive attitude and make sure that you need to make sure that everything should be like this. Yes, I can do this. Even if you encountered problem, don't panic. Say, I can do this. This is the behavior you should keep. Okay, link to this one. Address problems with the solution. See, if you are working on some work and you got some problem and your work got stuck there, what you will do? You will take that work to your manager and you will ask, so this is the problem I have. How to handle this? you will ask this kind of question to your manager? No, I would say don't do this first. First, you try to have solution for that problem, and you go with your manager. You can tell your manager, see, I have got this problem. I have solution for this. Do you agree with this solution? Can we go ahead with this solution? Your manager will think that, okay, this guy has something. He knows the things and he knows how to deal with the problems. This will create a better impression in front of your manager. So make sure that you don't go with the problems only. Try to find out the solution. See, it's not like that the solution should be sufficient. There is a possibility your manager can deny the solution. But that's fine. You can always go with the solution. At least your manager will think that, okay, this guy is keen to work on the work. Take ownership of the mistakes. So there is a well-known author, well-known scientist, Abdul Kalam. So when there's a failure, when he was unable to do a nuclear blast, do you think he will tell this one of my team members is not working properly? One of the team, this person has not worked properly. That is why it was a failure. No, he took the ownership. He told, no, this is my mistake. Because of my mistake, we were unable to do this. But if you remember, when there was a nuclear blast, he gave appreciation to entire team. He told that this is my team. My team has worked, completed the work, and that is why we were able to do this task. So make sure that you handle your team. It's not like that you start doing the blame games. This person has done, this person has not worked, that is why I am facing this difficulty. This person has not worked, that is why I am facing a difficulty. No, that kind of behavior is not gonna work in the corporate. You need to take ownership of the mistakes. And if you take the ownership of mistake, definitely no one is gonna ask you. Okay. Embrace lifelong learning. So you are in the corporate, you have learned many things in the college, and you think that, okay, that is sufficient. Technology will come. So while you are in the corporate, while you are working in the company, make sure that you are aware of the technology coming into the market, and make sure that you also learn the things. So whenever your company start to adopt new things, they will also absorb you. Otherwise, there is a possibility if they are changing their world, they are changing their techniques, and you are not absorbed, they may tell you, okay, sorry, we have stopped working on this. You can go ahead. Okay, realize that no one knows it all. See, you may be a genius, but regardless of your innate and intelligence, no one knows everything, you know, especially in a rapid changing information based society. One of the important business etiquette rules is listen to the suggestions of others, seek out the ways to collaborate actively. As I mentioned earlier, you need to listen to your co-workers properly. There is a possibility, though you are a manager, but your junior, you know, you are a manager at certain point of time, but you don't know everything, you know. You may know 80 things out of the 100 things, but there is a possibility that someone know that 20, you know, there is a gap of 20 things yet that you don't know. There is a possibility that person knows about that 20 things, you know. Try to, you know, grasp that thing. Try to learn that thing from your juniors also. You can learn it from the juniors. You can learn it from your seniors. Correct? So always have this behavior in the corporate. Learn to accept the constructive criticism. See, everyone's hackles rise when they feel they are being criticized. However, all criticism contains at least a kernel of truth. Learning to accept bad feedback is a crucial business etiquette skills. Instead of looking at the negative review as a proof of your boss hates you, use it as a starting place on the path towards the improvement. Don't feel that you are a bad guy. Don't feel like that. Try to absorb that criticism. See, first of all, I would say criticism is not at all good option. Criticize someone is not a good at all, but there is a possibility other person may have a different kind of opinion. They will try to criticize you. If person is criticize you in front of everybody, that's not good thing. But let's say your manager call to you and they will say, okay, come to your room. I want to discuss with you something. Okay. And in that meeting, on face-to-face meeting, one-on-one meeting, he is criticizing you. So what you will say? Okay, I am very bad guy. I can't work like this. You will start feeling low. See, make yourself prepared. Don't feel low. Usually, it's been observed that when there is a one-on-one meeting, you will get some criticism, definitely. So better you prepare for that criticism and make sure that you note that criticism and make yourself perfect for the criticism. Next time when there is a one-on-one meeting, your manager has to look, okay, last time I criticized for this thing, now he's perfecting this. Definitely he will feel better and you will create an impression in front of this. Behave honestly. Okay, honesty is the main thing. See, when you are working, and see, I will also always try to give this example, encountering problem when you are working, and this is the common thing I have observed in the corporate. You are working something, definitely there is a problem you will face in your work. So what you will do? You have encountered a problem. And do you think that you can hide it from your management? You can hide it from your manager? There is a possibility you may hide it from your manager. But in case, see, your manager is thinking that you are going to deliver something day after tomorrow. There is a problem you encountered, you try to deal with that by your own self. No, you can deal with it by your own self, but make sure that you inform this to your colleagues, you inform this to your managers. Correct? So in this way, you can, at least people know, okay, that person has the problem. There is a possibility that he may not deliver the work done day after tomorrow. And like that, at least they will have a plan in that way. People become ready with that, how to deal with the customer. Know what to keep confidential. So this is the, usually corporate has this is the very critical thing. Corporate wants their employee to keep their thing confidential. This is a red, sometimes this is like a zero tolerance policy for a company also. If they feels that person is declaring their confidential information in front of others, they will not like it. It's a zero tolerance policy for many companies. There is a possibility they may kick you out of the company. And why you want to declare confidential company information to other? Why want to tell see, when you are working for the company, make sure that you are working for the company. And you are actually working honestly with the company. You should try to avoid posting photos onto the Facebook which you have taken in your company background. There is a possibility that you may not have intended, but by mistake you have by mistake you have taken photo of something which company don't like to disclose on the Facebook. If you remember, BJP spokesperson Sambit Patra. So he took the photo from the sidelines, and that becomes a news. You know why that becomes a news? Because in that photo, people have started criticizing the person that he has created this environment just for the showcase. Because while he was giving the interview, we can see a book photo. But when other person had taken the photo from the different direction, we see that all the books were not there. It was just for the showcase. I'm not sure if I'm able to explain to you, but the person who knows about this news, definitely they understand me and they are able to guess this. So how this posting a photo from the office work, it's not advisable at all. If you still want to post a photo, take the photos which your company has posted already somewhere in some social network. Take that photo and you can post that. But don't take the photos from your PC, from your desktop, from your office work. Please don't do that. Okay, follow the handbooks. See, take the, don't use phone always. Make sure sometimes you use the notepad also for noting down something. Sometimes notepad is very, handful. You can go with the notepad, you can go with the pen. You may have some situation where you have to keep your phone in your pocket, or you have to keep your phone at your desk and you have to go for some room. You have to go for some meeting in the room. So make sure that you take the handbook and you go. Okay, behave. Okay. Behave in open offense situation. So, see, whenever, don't behave, this is one kind of gossiping thing. So don't make yourself that you are in a close corridor and you are working. No, you are in the work culture, that is a public place. Make sure that you are in the public. Ask when uncertain. Again, this is a part of the previous etiquettes. If you don't, you are not confident, you found the problems and you are not sure, make sure that you check with your colleague, come with the solution, ask your manager what is the thing which we can remove. Leave out your drama. See, he don't do drama. It's been observed that people are doing drama for taking the leaves. I'm sick today, I have this problem, I have marriages at my home. But hey, sometimes that is not the actual case. You may also done this thing in your college also, but make sure someday there is a possibility that you may caught. In this case, I would suggest, if you don't want to tell this thing, it's not necessary that you have to tell your office that I'm going for the marriage, I'm going for this thing, I'm going for this thing, I have this problem. You can always tell and you to your manager in your company, I have personal reasons, right? If you say I have personal reasons, that is the sufficient word. You don't have to tell them I have marriage, I have this thing. No, just use one word, I have a personal reason, that is why I'm taking the leave. You can say, I have a social occasion, that is why I'm taking the leave. I am not feeling well today, that is why I'm taking the leave. Don't start explaining that I have liver problem, I have kidney problem, I have this problem, I have this. No. You don't have to declare your illness to your company. Just say, I'm not feeling well, I want to take leave today. That's it. Usually, company, if you use this word, company believes the honesty. And if you use the word, they definitely consider your sick leave. But sometimes, if you're taking leaves for more than 2 days or 3 days, before your company asks, it is better that you go ahead and you ask your you give a company the information what they wanted actually. Correct? Practice firm handshake. I have seen Narendra Modi, our Prime Minister, is doing this kind of firm handshake when he's meeting Donald Trump. You can see the videos, you can Google it out, and you can see how to practice the firm handshake. Control your body language. You need to see, you can see my body language. If I'm trying to explain you, I'm moving my hand like this. I'm looking in front of you. I'm staring you. So make sure that you know all this thing, body language. I don't have to explain you this thing. You know everything properly. So make sure that you control your body language properly. Remember that colleagues have leaves out of the work. See, this is you know, you have office, let's say you have office hour in 9 to 5 p.m. and make sure that you have to complete your work in 9 to 5 p.m. Don't try to think that your person may have the personal life also. He is working for the company to earn money for his or her family. So you should always have work-life balance, where you need to work while you are work. You are, when you are at home, you should be at home. Don't get office work at home, and also don't get homework at the office. Learn email etiquettes. Usually in the corporate, it's believed that when you are telling something, you have to send them email. You can't see when there is an unofficial thing, you can talk to each other, you can speak to each other, that's fine. But when you are talking, it's an email talk. You don't have to, you know, it's if you're elevating something, it's an email talk. So see, you need to learn the email etiquettes. This is some different kind of topics you need to cover, but make sure that you learn the email etiquettes properly, because when you're writing the email, you are not in front of the person. How to write, how to use the proper words in the email, you need to learn this. And this is something which you can learn. Okay. Proofread all correspondence. Make sure whatever, see, anything in the corporate, it's a simple thing. Anything which is not documented is not done. So whatever you are doing, make sure that you are documenting somewhere. You can document in the email, you can document in the Microsoft Office, you can document in the form of hard copies also, but make sure you document it. If you don't document, that means that is not done. Handle sensitive matters privately. So see, this if you are involved in the gossiping, if you are involved, you feel that you want to talk with someone, make sure that you ask for the meeting with that person. Take that person in the room, check what is the problem. You ask them. So don't spread nuisance in the shop floor, in the office floor. Don't spread nuisance like this. There's a possibility that other people may come to, they will try to take benefits from both of you. So make sure that if two person have the problem, they have their personal talk in separately, in the close condition, and they resolve their own problems with each other. Don't try to take help from others, unless it's a professional thing. Otherwise, for personal thing, always have the close rule. So the golden rule. So I'm not gonna tell the golden rule, golden rule you can make by yourself. Make sure that you create one golden rule for you. There is a possibility different corporate has a different corporate work culture. You try to analyze that. You, after analyzing, you make sure that how I can avoid bad things, and you make golden rule for yourself. Okay, so this is I have provided you some general adequates which you may always have in the google.com, right? I have tried to convert that from my point of view. I tried to explain from my point of view, but now this is a few corporate observation I wanted to tell you that you may follow in the corporate. You can make yourself prepared before you step into the corporate. See, pre-corporate organization, see, one thing, plan your working day properly. It is always expected that work should be allocated in one day in advance. Anything which is not documented is not is considered not done. I already explained this to you. Other thing, manager leader is not your boss, correct? Person, manager or boss cannot yell at you. They cannot shout at you because he or she is just a colleague. She is a manager or he is a manager just because that is the role assigned to him or her. That doesn't mean that he is owning you and you are not a slave. Problem should be coupled with the solution. Already explained this to you. Trainee is a little baby. This is the always thumb rule in the, all the corporate. So make sure that you learn everything when you are training, because once you are done from your training period, definitely no one gonna come to you to train you. If you don't learn anything in those period, you will fall into the situation where you can't execute the things. So make sure that you learn properly when you are in a trainee role. Clean desktop policy. See, in the corporate, there are two things you need to follow: clean desktop policy and clean desk policy. Both the things you need to follow. Your desk should be very clean and neat. And even your desktop should be like this. Don't put all the files in the desktop. There is a possibility that a client may come and visit to you, your place, or your manager may also come to your place. So when they try to look at, when they come to your place, they may see the files which you placed on the desktop and which may contain some unnecessary thing. You may be working for the different client, so that you don't want to, so you don't want to disclose one client information to other client. So in those kind of scenario, make sure that you have a clean desktop policy. Just put a few files, remaining files you can create a folder inside the inside other folders, correct? Leave toilet clean for others. You like to see clean for yourself. So I'm just saying one sentence to you. I hope you guys can understand. This is the simple sentence. You can always follow. Documents should be shredded. So whatever, if you feel that some documents you may have, there is a correction required, and the old documents you need to, you need to send it to the dustbin. So don't throw it directly into the dustbin. There's a possibility that document may have some sensitive information. To make sure that you destroy that document instead of sending it to the dustbin. Do not waste paper unnecessarily. Company may give you printers, company may give you papers. I would suggest don't waste papers. I have seen this observation. Many people are wasting the papers. They don't do proofreadings. They don't do proper things when they are working on the Microsoft Word. That time they don't do correction. Once they take the printout, they get some errors. Okay, this is the error. Again, they will throw that papers and they go for the next printing. So please don't do that. Okay. Other thing, see, your work, if you are working, your work should be highlighted to higher roles, not limited to your managers. See, in this organization, make sure that it's not like that. Your work should also be highlighted to higher roles also. If you feel that your work is getting highlighted to your managers, definitely you can go and you can do the skip meeting skip meeting in the sense you can skip one roles. Let's say you have one manager, okay, and definitely there is one more manager on top of your manager, correct? So you can do the skip level meeting. If you feel that your work is not getting highlighted, you are not getting the awards, you are not getting the appreciated for the work you have done, definitely you can do the skip level meeting. In many corporates, this kind of adjustments are there. You can go ahead and you can check, you can do the skip level meetings. In the corporate, it is better good work should be appreciated and very good work should be awarded. If people don't get the appreciation, if people don't get, if they don't get award, they will start losing interest in the work. As I already mentioned, people like to have appreciation. If you give the appreciation, definitely they will work with the interest. So make sure that you don't create the hostile situation for your co-workers. Other thing that you need to take into the mind, all employees do not get the appreciation. All employees do not get the promotion. So, you know, if you see there is a team and if you get the promotion, you will become a manager one day or leader one day. And after manager, so, you know, out of the five candidates, only one will get promoted. So make sure that don't think that one day I'm going to get the promotion. Definitely one day your promotion will be stopped because there are other people and day by day competition will increase. Work-life balance, already mentioned to you. Do your work while you are at work. Do your home job when you are at home. Be loyal to organization. See, when you are working for the company, your company is paying you money, right? So don't try to do the gossiping against the organization. Don't speak my organization is not proper, their work culture is not proper. Don't try to spread this nuisance in front of other people. If you don't like the company, make sure that you leave that company, find out the other company. Spreading nuisance in front of others is not the good thing. But in case somebody comes to you, they ask you, what is this? They will come to you, they will ask you have worked on this company, right? So do you think that I should go and work in that company? That time you can provide your inputs. I have worked in a company. Definitely you can go ahead. That time you can put your thought in front of them. See, this is the situation I'm facing that. There is a possibility that you may have to work harder there. There is a possibility there is a client requirement. Clients are very possessive. Like that you can mention, right? But don't speak bad about the company. Okay? Respect our organizations and love your work. So see, until and unless your company, you are working in your company, you are not getting appreciation, you are not getting awarded, and still you are thinking that you are working, that means your company is not believing in you. You are not the asset for the company. So I would suggest you leave that company, find out other company, because you should work for the company until and unless you are asset for the companies. If company feels this person is not the asset, better you leave the organization and find out the other organization. Team bonding is very important thing. See, there is an unofficial thing that we also do, right? There is a possibility that you cannot go every time in an official way. There is a possibility you may not take the leave. You have some personal issues and you check with your team member and you will mention them, see, I have this problem, but there's a possibility that I have to work for the company organization. This is very urgent thing. That time team bonding will come into the picture. Your team member will say, don't worry, do your work, I will do overtime for you. So that should come from the heart. So when this will come from the heart, when there's a team bonding. Team bonding, see, remember, team bonding is very important when you're working in a team. If there is no team bonding, definitely efficiency of that team will get decreased. So with that, let me take you through some actual scenario where how we can where and how we can you know execute these etiquettes. Let me, okay. Yes. Okay, so this is the project plan I have created by myself. This is just a sample project plan. So see how company works. I just want to give a highlights to all of you. With this, I think you can get some idea how this etiquettes works while you are working in the company. So let's say this is the, you got the requirement for the software update. Okay, you have the requirement for the three softwares, task one, task two, task three. And you know you need to complete this task by 14 Jan. So first you need to make sure you assign the priority, what is high, what is medium, what is low. Okay, so we'll just discuss on the software one update. So how, see here, you need to do the planning. We need to complete by 14 Jan. You have to start on the 21st Jan. So how you will do the planning? So this is the, so first you will receive the requirement. Who will receive the requirement? Team lead. Team lead, so what do you say? Team, you got the requirement and you start allocating the work to the team. Is that the proper way? No, it's not the proper way. First you need to ask your team whether you will be able to work in this time period or not, right? You have two people, you have three people in your hand. You need to plan it accordingly. So see, first once you get the requirement, you should do the impact analysis meeting. In the impact analysis meeting, team lead usually asks, you know, there is a team member like designer, programmer, validation team. You can ask the team whether you will be able to complete this thing or not. It's not like the team lead is going to, you know, force the someone. No, you have to work like this. If people are unable to work, or people are unable to complete work in some days, you need to ask resource from the management. Okay, you have to analyze these things. So, and you also get the promise. It's not like you can throw, no, I don't know anything. Somehow you complete the work in 2 days. No, you need to check with your team member, ask your team member that we are going to plan. Okay, and you need to start designing on the front. Let's say you are talking with the designer, take the commitment from the designer that you need to complete your designing of software from 4th June to 5th June, correct? Will you be able to complete this in the 5th June? Under trust from them. Then designer will say, no, that's not possible. I cannot complete in the 2 days. So you can negotiate the timelines with them under trust from the designer. And at last, let's say if designers agree, okay, I will complete in 2 days. Let's have it this date or ask for another resource. Okay. In the same way, you can plan your work for the programmer 6th June. So he will say, I will take 3 days. So like that, you have to plan the days. You need to make sure that you are planning it properly. So here, if you see the etiquettes, you can see you are earning the trust from the team. You are planning the day. You are going to give a plan. So everybody knows when they need to start the work. Everybody knows how to work. And if the person by self, see, you are not forcing them, you don't have to force them, no, you have to work on 9 June. No, if person is unable to do that, no, that's not the possibility. Take the promise from that, and person should promise from the heart. If person is committing by themselves, definitely that person is going to work on 9 June, right? So once you get this kind of slots and you can complete your work, you can create a software and you can push that software into production on 14 Jan as planned. I wanted to explain you, I know, in details, but considering the time strains, this is the situation. But you can use this you know, something kind of project plan, and you can think about yourself what kind of etiquettes you can use while using this project plan, you know. So this is it from my side. Thank you so much for allowing me this presentation in the webinar. Thank you, Bindi ma'am. Thank you, Parul University. Do let me know if you have any questions.
Thank you, sir. Anandita ma'am, do you have any questions to ask?
Yes, ma'am, I have a question. There is a topic called learn to say no, okay, which we teach to our students. So how can we say sometimes no to our boss, specifically when we are in corporate field, without being rude? How can we say no? This is a question which is being given by a lot of students. They ask while they go to any industrial background or professional profession. So this is what question to you, sir.
Okay.
How to say no?
Okay, how to say no, right? This is a big question. You need to learn the say how to say no. See, one thing, when person is like, let's say you always have to say no to your team lead. Definitely the person is allocating task to you, right? So if you want to say no, see, you can always tell that. See, first of all, you need to analyze whether words given to you is in accordance with the time or not. You can explain your team lead or manager that, see, this is things, I have this many work in my hand, I have this thing, I have only 2 hours in my hand, in 2 hours I may not be able to complete this work, right? So in case you can say I have to leave this office by 5 p.m. right? So maybe if you have 5 p.m. timelines, 9 to 5, you can say, okay, I'm going to leave this. I have personal commitments at my home. I need to fulfill that commitment. Straightforward, you can say, no, sorry, I cannot work. I have 2 hours. If you work for 2 hours, I can work for 2 hours. Or is there is a possibility that I can work from tomorrow 9 morning? If that is the case, please do let me know. Your manager can't force you to work after office hours. I'm sorry. I'm
thank you.
I
thank
hope
you,
this
sir.
Is the correct answer, because I'm getting some difficulty. Speech volume is very low. I'm getting difficult to hear this. Hope this is answer okay. Your question.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Means a lot. The words which came from you really enlightened us. Thank you so much. Like this kind of webinar will really help us and also the students exactly. Now I would like to request Bindi ma'am to carry forward with vote of thanks.
Thank you, Anandita ma'am. So Priyan sir and Anandita ma'am and the webinar team, it's been a grand pleasure. It's a great pleasure for us to conduct this type of topic in front of the students in this webinar. And thank you, Priyan sir. It's been a great helpful etiquette or the things that you have analyzed here. And it is going to be very helpful for the students to elaborate or to enhance in their career. And in this condition, you utilize your time and you give your time, valuable time here. So we are very thankful to you. Thank you very much to come and give your speech over here. Thank you, sir. It is going to be very well, very much helpful to all of us.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Okay, so with that, we can conclude this webinar. Thank you so much. Thank you, Parul University. Thank you, Bindi ma'am. Thank you, Anandita ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.